Hello student, good morning. This is Sarjan with your new subject computer. So you can see your book here, Supercomputer Part 1. Today on what you are going to learn computer. So before starting it, let us show you our lab. You can see here our lab. I am missing you all. You all may be missing our lab also. Is it? Okay students, so let's come to our topic. Today we will first start our chapter 1, that is computer fundamental. Fundamental means basic. What are the basic operation of a computer? So first I will tell you what is a computer. A computer is an electronic device, and how it works? It works with the instruction what we give to it, and it process later it will give us a result. That is what we call output. So in a computer we can do several kind of activities like calculating, doing different kind of mathematical operation, drawing, painting, printing, reading, browsing internet, doing online shopping, everything, whatever activities are there. Nowadays we are using computer. So in everywhere we can see computer, like in school lab, in airport, in office, in bank. So nowadays our life is completely depend on a computer system. So in your chapter you can see computer fundamental. So I have written here the main basic operation or the work of a computer. You can see first one, input. How a computer work? Input means whatever data or the information we give to a computer. It may be a raw data or any words or any numerical sign or any voice or any clip, whatever are there, we give through it input. So whenever we give input data, what we use? We use input device. Input device means mouse, keyboard, microphone, graphic tablet, barcode scanner. This kind of devices are input. That means using input device, we try to give the information or the data into a computer. And then computer start working on it. What data we have given, the computer start work on this data. That process is called processing, and that is called process. And how it works? Using the CPU main part of it, we call brain of a computer, the CPU used to process the data, and later we get output or the result. Output means result. So where we get output? We get the output or the result in a output device. That means in a monitor or in a projector or in a printer. Whenever we print any document, we get the output result. So one example I will give you. Suppose I have to write the application. So what I will do? I will open Microsoft Word 2007 or 2008 or sorry 2010. Then what I will do? I will give input data. That means using keyboard, I will write the application. And then what I will do? I will first save it. Whenever I save a data, what will happen? The data will directly go to the storage system of a computer in a hard disk. It will directly go to a hard disk, and later the data again we can use. So where we can use it? By this storage system. And during this time, if I am going to print this document or the application, I will get this output by a printer. The printer will print this document, I will get, and then I will get this result or the application. So this is the main process or the fundamental process of a computer. That means first we will give input to a computer, then computer will start on working on it. That means it will process, and this time the storage is needed. Without storage we cannot work in a computer. Storage is very, very much important. That means hard disk, and then later we will get this output data. It is called IPO cycle. That means input, process, output cycle. Okay. So this is the main fundamental operation of a computer. So in this process, there are other activities also. In next class, we will discuss about it, like CU, that means control unit, how a control unit will work, ALU, arithmetic logical operation, how it will work. So in this topic, we will learn in next class. So today, we have only discussed this topic, that means main fundamental operation, input, process and output. One another example I can give you here. You have seen calculator. How a calculator work? If we have to do any math or we have to add there, if we have to add 5 plus 5. So this 5 and 5 are input. Whenever I click this plus button, it will start process. That means the plus button is help us to process the data. And later, whenever we click equal button, then the output will display at calculator. So this output will be the 10. The result is called output. So the same way the computer also works. We give information to a computer or data to a computer. Computer will perform it and later we get the result. This is the main process or the fundamental process of a computer. Okay, students, so for today, this much only. In next class, we will learn about CU and arithmetic logical operation. Thank you.